Welcome to my channel, guys. So in this video, I'm going to be reviewing a 2014 horror thriller, The Shrew's Nest. This movie was produced by Alex de la Iglesia, who I know for directing such movies as The Last Circus, which I really enjoy. And I mistakenly thought that he directed this movie as well, which is why I watched it. Turned out that he just produced it, but it is what it is. By that time, I had already watched it. And to be honest, I don't particularly regret watching it neither. So apparently this movie, some people are calling it like a cross between Misery and Whatever Happened to Baby Jane. I've never seen Whatever Happened to Baby Jane, so I have no idea what that is. But if The Shrew's Nest is kind of similar to that, I actually kind of want to check that out now. But as far as Stephen King's Misery is concerned, yes, this movie definitely seemed like a Spanish language, very, very twisted version of Misery, like Misery on steroids or some shit. So in this movie, the main character, Monse, is a severely agoraphobic woman who is haunted by memories of her abusive father and sometimes even imagines conversations with him. She lives in a small apartment with her younger sister, whom she basically raised, as well as being extremely strict and abusive to her at times. One day their upstairs neighbor Carlos knocks on their door after falling down a flight of stairs. He is injured and in need of help. So Monse takes him in and she nurses him back to health, and in the process becomes to fall obsessively in love with him and will stop at nothing to prevent him from ever leaving her apartment ever again. So basically the plot doesn't sound like anything innovative. And like I said, like it's been compared to Misery, and I can think of quite a few other films with like a similar variations of this plotline that has been done before, but I definitely enjoyed this version of it. This movie was definitely very creepy. It's a bit of a slow burn, like the first half of it especially. It feels very atmospheric, moody and creepy and slow paced, and also very intense. And then in the second half of the movie, all hell breaks loose and things get bloody, violent, gory, and at times a little bizarre as well. Some pretty cool visuals in the second half of the movie. 95% of this movie takes place inside of Monse's apartment due to her agoraphobia. And in turn, that makes us, the viewers, feel extremely claustrophobic. Like, I literally felt like the walls of the apartment were at times suffocating me. And I felt like it actually had some pretty nice cinematography as well, even though, like, it's always in the same setting and seemingly not much to see, but I felt like they managed to get some really nice, interesting shots in there. And whenever it came to, like, all the blood and gore, it was really well done and very effective, very bloody and very twisted. I really liked the acting in this movie. I thought that everybody was great, especially the lead actress, Macarena Gomez. She was just a force to be reckoned with in this movie, to be honest. At times, she scared the shit out of me. But I feel like even though she was a clear villain in this movie, she was also at times very deeply sympathetic, and you couldn't help but to feel for her at some point. She does some pretty fucked up things in this movie, but when you learn her backstory, it's kind of hard not to sympathize with her, at least in some way. And all three of the main characters were definitely interesting. Monse definitely being the most developed character though, and Carlos probably being the least developed. And the most annoying, like, Carlos annoyed me sometimes in this movie, and so did the little sister at times, to be honest. But even though she was at times annoying, she was actually also a very sympathetic and likable character at the same time. The movie definitely got me at the edge of my seat, had me biting my nails sometimes, gave me a few anxiety attacks. It also had me kind of conflicted, because at times I didn't even know who the hell to root for. Like, your perspective kind of always changes on which character you want to make it out of this hellhole alive. And then, at times, it was also a little bit predictable, not even gonna lie. Certain plot points in this movie were predictable, and there was a little twist towards the end concerning Monse and her sister, which I kind of saw coming about halfway through the movie. It's not really that hard to figure out. But that being said, the movie still keeps you engaged and involved enough. It still keeps you interested. It's one of those movies that I feel like once you started watching it, there's no way in hell you can just turn it off, because you just have to know exactly what would happen next. There were also moments that were a little bit unintentionally hilarious to me. Like, there was that one scene, for example, where one character got poisoned, and that scene just played out as funny to me, even though I'm not sure that it was intended to be so. And then there was, like, other moments in the movie like that as well. But then there was also moments that are almost terrifying. Watching Monte lose her grip on her sanity more and more was definitely nothing to laugh about. The ending was sad and kind of haunting as well, and definitely stayed with me for a long time after the ending credits rolled. Overall, it was definitely a crazy-ass movie, and I definitely recommend it. I would give this movie, like, an 8 out of 10. So thank you guys for watching. Like this video if you enjoy my review, subscribe to my channel, all that good stuff, and I'll see you in the next video, okay? Bye!